This video is about the exponent rules that given expressions like 2 to the fifth or x to the n. 2 to the fifth is the just shorting for 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 written 5 times, and simply x to the n is the just x multiplied by itself and times. When we write this expression, the number on the bottom that is p multiplied by itself is called the base, and the number on the top telling us how many times we are multiplying this base by itself called the exponent. Sometimes the exponent is also called the power. The product rule says that 5x to the power of n times x to the power of m, that's the same the things as to the m plus m power. In other words, when I multiply two expressions with the same base, then I can add their exponents. For example, if I have 2 cubed times 2 to the 4th, that is equal to 2 to the 7th, and that makes sense because 2 cubed times 2 to the 4th means I multiply 2 by itself 3 times, and then I multiply that by 2 multiplied by itself 4 times. And in the end, I have to multiply by itself 7 times, which is the 2 to the 7th. I am just adding up to the number of times I multiply in each piece to get of times I multiply total. The quotient rule says that if I have x to the n power divided by x to the m power, that equal to x to the m minus m power. In other words, if I divide the two expression with the same base, that I can subtract their exponents. For example, 3 to the 6 divided by 3 squared is going to the 3 to the 6 minus 2 or 3 to the 4th, and this makes sense because 3 to the 6 means I multiply 3 by itself 6 times, and then I divided that by 3 multiplied by itself twice. So when I cancel out 3, I have 4, 3 left. Notice that I have to subtract the number of these of 3 on the bottom for 3 at the top to get my number of 3 remaining. That's why I subtract my exponents. The power rule tell us if I have x to the n power days to the power, that's the same things as x to the n times m power. In other words, when I raise a power to a power, I get to multiply the exponents. For example, 5 to the 4th cubed is equal to 5 to the 4 times 3 or 5 to the 5th 12th, and this makes sense because 5 to the 4th cubed can be taught to the 4th times 5 to the 4th times 5 to the 4th, expanding this out the same, or that's 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 times the same things times the same thing again. So I have 3 groups of 4 or 5, which is the total of 3 times 4 or 12 5s. The next rule involves what happens when I raise a number or a variable to the power. It turns out that anything to the zeros power is equal to 1. Usually, this is just taken as a definition, but there why it makes sense to me. If you have something like 2 cubed divided by 2 cubed, well, certainly that has to equal 1. Anything divided by itself is just 1, but using the quotient rule. We know that this is the same things as the 2 to the 3 minus 3, because when we divide the two things with the same base, we get to subtract their exponent. Therefore, this is the same things as the 2 to the 0, so 2 to the 0 has to equal 1 in order to make it work with the quotient rule. And the same argument shows that anything to the 0 power has to equal to 1. What happens when we take something to a negative power? X to the n equal to the over x to the n again. Most people just take this as the definition of negative exponent, but there why it makes sense. If I take something like 5 to 7 times 5 to the negative 7, then by the product rule, the SAS to equal 5 to the 7 plus negative 7, which is the 5 to 0. And we just said that that is equal. Now I have to the equation of 5 to the 7th times 5 to negative 7th equals 1. If I divide it both sides by 5, the 7th, I get that 5 to the negative 7th has to equal 1 over 5 to the 7th. So that's where this rule about negative exponents comes from. That has to the true order to be consistent with the product rule. Finally, let's look at the fraction exponent. What does an expression like x to the 1 over n really means? Well, it means that n's root of x, for example, 64 to the 1 over 3 power, means that a cube root of 64, which happens to be 4, and 9 to the 1 half means that square root of 9, which is usually written without that little subscript up there. Now, the square root of 9 is just 3. Fractional exponent also makes sense. For example, if I have 5 to the 1 of 3 and I cube that, then by the power rule, that's equal to 5 to the 1 over 3 times 3, which is just 5 to the 1 over 5. So in other words, 5 to the 1 over 3 is the number that when you cube it, you get 5, and that's exactly what means by the cube root of 5. The cube root of 5 is also a number that when you cube it, you get 5. The next rule tells us we can dispute an exponent over product. In other words, if we have a product x times y and raised to the nth power, that's equal to x to the n times y to the n. For example, 5 times 7. Or raised to the third power is equal to 5 cubed times 7 cubed. And this makes sense because 5 times 7 or raised to the cube power can be expanded as 5 times 7 times 5 times 7 times 5 times 7. But if I rearrange the order of multiplication, this is the same thing as 5 times 5 times 5 times 7 times 7 times 7 or 5 cubed times 7 cubed. Similarly, we could distribute an exponent over quotient if we have the quotient x over y or raised to the n power, that's the same as x to the m over y to the n. For example, 2 sevenths raised to the fifth power is the same thing as 2 to the fifth. Over 7 to the fifth, this makes sense because 2 sevenths to the fifth can be expanded as 2 sevenths multiplied by itself 5 times, which can be rewritten as the multiply by itself 5 times divided by 7 multiplied by itself 5 times, and that 2 to the fifth over 7 to the fifth as 1. We can substitute an exponent over multiplication and division. But be careful because we cannot distribute next power over addition or subtraction. For example, a plus p to the n is not generally equal to a to the n plus p to the n minus p to the n is not generally equal to a to the n minus b to the n. And if you are not sure, just try an example with the numbers. For example, 2 plus 3 squared is not the same thing as 2 squared plus 3 squared. And 2 minus 3 squared is definitely not equal to the square minus 3 squared. In this video, I gave 8 exponent rules, which I shall list again here. They are the product rule, equation rule, the power rule, the fractional exponent, the zero exponent, the negative exponent, and the two rule involving distribution exponent across multiplication and division. In